Okay, so now let's recap. If you're still working on this assignment, we are now factoring out the greatest common factor. That was assignment number two. And obviously the crucial step here is that we have the capabilities of acquiring a greatest common factor. So if you're still working on that, make sure you're going back to IXL AA1, because that was the assignment that was helping you acquire that skill. Okay? So let's look at the process for how we're gonna do this. Now there's a couple things that are gonna play a role here. There's some rules, I'll work this out for you and remind you of all those things. But the key for step one is to look at this binomial and just look at each term and ask yourself, what's the greatest common factor? And hopefully we come up with 3z, right? 3z is the greatest number, the greatest common factor between both terms. So what we're gonna do here is I'm gonna write the greatest common factor on the outside, and I'm gonna open parentheses. Because what's left inside is gonna be the division between this and this. So I'm gonna write that 3z cubed, which is what that was, and now I'm dividing it by the greatest common factor, minus 6z, and I'm gonna divide that by the greatest common factor. Okay, so let's go back over what I did. I looked at it and said, what's my greatest common factor? And I got 3z, so I wrote that on the outside. I opened parentheses, and I divided that by my greatest common factor. And now what we're gonna do is we're just gonna simplify the inside of the parentheses. Well, what's 3z cubed divided by 3z? You see these threes would cancel, so there's only a number one that's left. Z to the third over z is z squared. Remember, there's a rule for that. I'll do that over here. Remember that if you have a division where the bases are the same, you're supposed to subtract the exponents. That's supposed to be an n. I'll make that an n. So the bases are the same in a division problem, subtract the exponents. So the bases were the same, they were z's. So this was 3 minus 1, which is 2. Minus 6 divided by 3 is 2. And z to the first power over z to the first power cancel. So there it is. There is factoring out the greatest common factor. Now we want to make sure that we can go back and check our answer. We can check our answer by the distributive property. So if we want to make sure, is this right? Well, let's multiply that back in to see what that would give us. 3z times z squared is 3z cubed minus 3z times 2 is 6z, and does that match the original problem? And it does. So we know that that's the answer right there. That was what we would get if we factored out the greatest common factor. Okay, so again, I'll just work through this process. Again, I'll recap. We found the greatest common factor. We wrote it on the outside, we opened parentheses, and we divided that by the greatest common factor, each piece, reduced, and got our answer. Remember, you can always check by the distributive property to make sure you are right, okay? So here's another example. So look at it and say, to yourself, well, what's the greatest common factor? Go ahead and come up with that on your own. Pause the video, see if you can work this out. Play it when you're done. Okay, hopefully you got 3f squared. Notice that a 3 belongs to both. You can divide 3 by 3, you can divide 9 by 3, and they both have at least 2 f's, f squared. So I'm gonna take out the greatest common factor and open parentheses. 3f squared. And then I'm just going to divide each one of those by the greatest common factor. So I'll rewrite it here, 3f cubed divided by 3f squared plus 9f squared divided by 3f squared. Now the only thing left to do is simplify the inside. So I have 3f squared, and what's left? Well, the threes are gonna cancel. And if I have f squared over, or f to the third over f squared, remember when the bases are the same, you can subtract the exponents. So 3 minus 2 is 1. So this is just f to the first power plus 9 divided by 3 is 3. And f squared over f squared is 1. So it would be like 3 times 1. So there's the answer right there. Again, we'll check it. Is 3f times f going to produce 3f to the third? Well, it does. And is 3f squared times 3 going to be 9f squared? And it is. So we know we're right, right here, as we were able to check our answer. Okay? So again, finding the greatest common factor, opening parentheses, dividing each piece by the greatest common factor, reducing to the answer. So let's just keep doing that so we can get that in our noodle. So what is the greatest common factor between 4h to the third power plus 6h? Go ahead and pause it, see if you can come up with it. Okay, so hopefully you came up with 2h. 2h is the greatest common factor between these two terms. So now I'm just going to take this and divide them in. So 4h squared is now being divided by 2h. And 6h is now being divided by 2h. And all I have to do now is reduce the inside. 4 divided by 2 is 2. H squared over H is H plus 6 divided by 2 is 3. And you can see these H's are going to cancel. And there's the answer. Again, you can look back and check it. 2H times 2H is, I missed my 3. Sorry. That's actually a square. See how checking your answer is helpful? So I just caught my mistake by checking my answer. So if we multiplied it back here, we'd get 2 times 2, which is 4, and h times h squared is h to the third power. So I was missing a 2 there. And 2h times 3 is 6h. So there's the answer. Check your answer. It's really helpful. Okay? Let's look at this one. What is the greatest common factor between 20d squared plus 5? Greatest common factor, hopefully you're going to come up with, is just the number 5. And again, now we're going to divide each piece by the greatest common factor. 20d squared over 5 plus 5 over 5. And this should tell us what the answer is if we factor out the greatest common factor. So in this case, we have 20 fifths, which is 4. And there's a d squared that gets to hang out there. Plus 5 divided by 5 is 1. Again, you can look back and just check your answer real quick. If I multiply this, am I going to produce a 20d squared? I am. 5 times 4 is 20. The d squared comes for the ride. And if I multiply here, is 5 times 1? 5. So it is. So there's the answer. Okay? Let's see. I think this is the last one. So go ahead and pause it. See if you can get this right. Factor out the greatest common factor first. Let's see what that is. And we can kind of run through this, right? You know, 15 would be 1, 3, 5, and 15, and over here you got 18, which is more numbers, like 1 times 18, 2 times 9, 3 times 6. Hopefully we can come up with the fact that they share a 3. That's the greatest number they share. And the greatest number of variables would be w squared. So let's open parentheses and divide those out. So 15 w cubed and divide by the greatest common factor. And see what we get. 15 divided by 3 is 5. W cubed divided by W squared. Again, bases are the same. Let's subtract those exponents. 3 minus 2 is 1. So that's 5W to the first power. Minus 18 divided by 3 is 6. And a W squared divided by a W squared. Those cancel, or you get W to the 0 power, which is just 1. And there's the answer. Let's see if we go back and check. If I multiplied this, 3 times 5, well, I'll get a 15, w squared times w, there's my w to the third, and multiply it here, 3 times 6, 18, w squared comes to the right. So there's the answer. Okay? All right, good job.